To begin, please go to your browser and click aas237.vfares.com. Once there, it will bring you to the landing page for vFares. Then click Attendee Login. You will then enter your username and password given at registration. If you need help, please contact reghelp@aas.org. Once you've logged into the system, you will then return to the landing page, at which point you want to begin by first editing your profile. Once you're on the landing page, in the upper right-hand corner will be your profile information. Click Edit Profile, and you can update all information that you see here. First name, last name, email, affiliation, and so forth. Once done, please click Update. Your profile will then be updated. Once on the landing page, you will notice at the top right-hand corner, there is a navigation bar. The navigation bar shows you the three exhibit halls, the lobby, Slack, networking lounge, everything you're going to find on the main lobby. In the lobby itself, you want to use the point and click in order to enter each of the areas. If you are a first-time attendee, please click the tips and tricks. Starting here, you want to click the schedule and online itinerary. It will show you session types as well as search by days of the week. You will also log into your online itinerary. Apologies, I did not log in yet, so that you can add sessions to your personal itinerary. Once you're in a session and you'd like to add it to your personal calendar to see specific sessions, you would simply click any session type. Go to that session. Over to the right, you will see the itinerary button. It should be not grayed out, but then you will log in and add that particular session to your itinerary. Going back to the main lobby, you want to be sure to click the auditorium in order to view the day's schedule of events. Inside, you will see the days of the week, session title, session number. You will also see the Slack channel associated with that session. If you scroll down, you will see all the sessions scheduled for that particular day. Included is also a session description. Over to the right, where you see in green the date and time, if your session is set to start within 5 minutes of that scheduled start time, the date and time becomes a join button. If you'd like to click in to find out more about the session or read an abstract, you would hit the More Info button, to which it would bring you back to the online planner. If you click Chat on Slack, it takes you to that particular session's Slack channel. That session was the Splinter NASA PCOS FizzPadge. So you'll see here I have my session, my channels organized by days of the week, and I went to that particular session. Going back up to the top of the screen, you'll notice the navigation bar will take you back to the main lobby. In the lobby, I then click on the NSF Pavilion because I want to review videos by NSF and see what exhibitors are in this hall itself. You can click into the videos on the screen, or you can click the particular booth to find out more about that particular exhibitor. From the About Us section, you can see various things listed in their booth, right down to reserve a chat slot if you want to speak to that particular exhibitor directly. Navigating back to the main lobby, I'm going to use the navigation bar here at the top of the screen. Once back in the lobby, I decide I want to go see the grad school fair. Click on the word graduate school fair and it will bring you to the graduate hall. You will see videos, you will see different booths by different educational institutions, as well as things in their booth like their chat rooms, or to reserve a chat time as well. Clicking into this particular exhibitor, it looks like they have a chat room here, and we would go in and see and begin discussions with that exhibitor. Going back again to the main lobby, we want to scroll down. We will see the networking lounge. In the networking lounge, you'll see the NASA exhibit button, right down to all of the social media channels that you can engage in conversation on, from the AAS Twitter to the Facebook page. Going back to the main lobby here, we will then go into iPoster Gallery. The iPoster Gallery will open up the gallery itself, to which you are welcome to scroll through and read any of the published iPosters that are available. Navigating back to the main lobby, you'll want to go to the auditorium to see what oral sessions are beginning at this time. In the oral sessions, I decided I want to see the iPoster Turbo Talks. Turbo Talks are new feature to this meeting. You will see 2-minute summaries of iPosters that have been published in the gallery. Simply click the play button to view those summaries. Going back to the main lobby, if I wanted to click into the Sky and Telescope's booth and see what's going on over here, I would simply click the Sky and Telescope image and then come into the video booth. Once in it, I can add items from their booth into the swag bag. Going back up to the main navigation bar, I then click my swag bag to see the items that I've added. Whether it be videos or documents, you can store those items for yourself or simply email them to yourself for viewing at a later time. If you click the email button, you will then select all items and enter the email address that you'd like to send the items to. Navigating back again to the main lobby, we will then review the live help desk. Should you have any questions or need any help, you will simply click into the live help desk, click chat with a technician, and it will then bring you to the chat room in which there will be tech support should you need any additional assistance. It brings you right into the tech support chat room for a discussion with the tech host. Navigating back again to the main lobby, the next area is press conferences. It brings you to the daily schedule of press conferences. Each press conference also has a Slack channel, so you are welcome to discuss the particular topics of those press conferences. From there, you can also navigate days of the week, or you can navigate using the search bar by typing in a session number. If you type in the session number, it brings up all sessions with that title. You may also search by topic areas like plenaries. If you search by plenaries, it brings up each day of the week that a plenary is scheduled, and you can navigate to that particular day using the date line. From that, navigating back to the main lobby, if you decide from the main lobby you'd like to just enter the Slack channels and just begin discussion or have direct messages, you can click chat on Slack and come back to the Slack channels, to which you are welcome to have direct messages with the fellow colleagues and attendees. You can sort by the different channels, doing days of the weeks. You can also check for any mentions and reactions of anyone that's looking for you or looking to discuss things with you in Slack. Navigating back again to the main lobby, we will then end our tutorial by logging out of the system. Once you log out of the system, all your information is stored for the next day. Should you have any questions or concerns or need additional help, please contact meetings@aas.org for additional assistance. Thank you for your time. We look forward to having you participate in the virtual meeting. Have a great day.